like numbers. For me, the problem of physics were like games to solve. But then I realized that I liked even more to play with the system. So I slowly switched from the numbers to the experiments. And at the moment, what an experimentalist does is to work with both. The problem which we are trying to solve is how to play with supercurrents, which are the currents in superconductors that do not dissipate heat. Conventional circuits, the one which we have in our computer, they work with normal currents. When they flow, they dissipate heat. And there is nothing you can do with that except using superconductor. And why is this interesting? Besides the fact that perhaps in the future we could have a circuitry that saves energy. At the moment, the pressing problem are quantum computers. So basically, in quantum computer, one has superconducting circuits, and what we would like to do is to find the equivalent in superconducting circuit of elements which we have already in normal circuit. And one example of this is the diode. So in my research in the last year, we focused on superconducting diodes, particularly in so-called Josephson junction. In a normal conductor, you have your batteries with plus and minus. You connect with a piece of copper and the current starts flowing. The electron go from the minus to the plus, and in doing so, they dissipate heat. And this process can only happen in one direction. But in superconductor, there is no dissipation, so there is a completely equivalence. The current can flow in one direction and in another, so both directions are equivalent. And to break this symmetry, we need to break the time reversal symmetry, and this we do it with magnetic field. And we also need to break the spatial symmetry, something that tells us that the left is different from the right. And for this, we need special material where this symmetry is broken at the atomic level. By breaking all this symmetry, at the end we managed to get an equivalent in superconducting circuit of a normal diode, and that's really great. So for physicists, the breaking of symmetry is something that is always cool. Probably we never managed to convey this to non-physicists, but physicists are really, really attracted by the breaking of symmetry. Superconductors, unfortunately, work, at least so far, they work only at low temperature. What we do here is to study electronic systems which are so delicate that they require that the energy of electrons and atoms is so low that they don't disturb the very delicate coherent dance of this electron. To say that all what we do here is possible because of the great work that our PhD students do. So what I and Professor Strunk, we are the leads of our group, what we do is basically coordinating this work, but a big part of the work is done by the students themselves, and what is great is that they have a cooperative spirit, so they work together, and the personal atmosphere, the relation between the students is great, so this is a real advantage for our work. This topic indeed received a big hype. Many groups are working on this Josephson diodes or in general superconducting diodes because of potential application. But what we are doing is not that. So our goal as a university is a more fundamental research. We use this effect as a signature of new physics.